Good evening, everyone. I'm Corrupt here, and tonight we're playing some Ether 1. This is a game I've owned for quite some time. I believe it was a PS Plus game sometime in, I want to say February, maybe March. But for some reason, I never got around to actually playing it. So tonight, we're actually going to dive in and see what this is all about. I checked the Metacritic before deciding what to play tonight, and this one's got some pretty polarizing reviews. It's sitting at about 75. But there's a lot of very bad reviews, and there's a lot of like pretty good reviews, so I want to see for myself what this game's all about.
It's me. Listen,
Subtitles
I'm sorry
are a
for the
bit
things
fast.
I said
That's
earlier
weird.
On. It's just, God, I really don't think you should go to that place. I don't think they care. Not like they should. And before you think it, I know how it feels to want to feel safe, to want more. You know I do it, but Jesus, do you know how they view you? Just another patient to squeeze money out of. Please. Don't go tonight. I'm freaking scared. For you and for me.
We teach, they restore. You remember. Ether. Huh. Keeping your fondest memories alive. Well, I'm already digging the art direction, so that's a good first step. Hold L1 to identify objects of interest. Ethereal rock.
In the mid-19th century, advances in genetic and psychological sciences led to a series of astounding breakthroughs regarding the human genome. At the forefront of these experiments, the Ishin Initiative discovered and developed new ways of mapping the human mind, expanding the knowledge of our species. In the mid-19th century, advances in genetic and psychological sciences led to a series of astounding breakthroughs regarding the human genome. At the forefront of these experiments, the Ishin Initiative discovered and developed new ways of mapping the human mind, expanding the knowledge of our species.
Klaxons.
1942. Whilst the world was at odds with itself, the Ishin Initiative discovered Patient Zero.
I'll have missed the first injection. And now, this might cause some slight discomfort.
And shortly after, the Ether Institute was born. With it, a completely new way to navigate the human brain. Projection. Allowing scientists to access areas of the conscious mind previously undiscovered by medicine, placing our scientific studies at the apex of modern technology.
Okay. Brody Blackwell, Martin Williams, Robert Beard, and Ben Hislop?
Is that? It is. Oh, this is excellent. We're so glad to have you back. My name is Dr. Edmonds, but you can call me Phyllis if you like. Right. There should be a register on the reception desk. So once you've signed in, grab the key card from the top drawer and head on down. You will need it to gain access to the lower floors.
Restoration procedure for patient
JN2057
will commence shortly. Staff are advised to prepare chambers for initial projection.
Well, it seems you best get a move on. There's plenty to do, and for you, plenty to see and discover. I'm going to be guiding you through the process of restoration this evening, and hopefully ensuring that nothing terrible happens to you or our client.
That would be nice.
I'm in restoration chamber number 3. Now, if you don't mind, would you be a dear and head on down?
Aren't I supposed to write on the registrar? Like, oh, there we go. Oh, okay. Okay. Wrote my name down. Oh, here we go. Behind the stairs.
The Restorer. The next step in human evolution. An asset to society.
How are you guys doing tonight? What do we have here? Well, that's mean. Oh, okay, so that's where I'm supposed to go, so I'm gonna go check the computer first, and then we're gonna check out that other hallway. Industrial mining? That's weird. Whoa, that was weird. Restorers can only carry one item at a time. That's not good. Oop, drawers, drawers, drawers. Check the drawers. Ha ha ha. Alright, so this one's 2.671002, the one that I have. Is 2.671.0045.6. Is this the same? Looks like it's the same. That's weird. That's actually coming up as projector, so I must be able to do something with this at some point. Blank book. Oops. Got some booze. Not a pill bottle, a pill pot. Is that like normal English terminology? It's a pill pot, not a pill bottle. Can I even get out of here without a key card? I sure can't. Okay. Let's go grab one of those bad boys. Even though they appear to be identical. Yeah. These doors are very sensitive. Well, this area's like really big. Definitely some weird business going on. A door with no switch. That's not generally very good to find.
Sometimes these procedures don't, how should I put it, go to plan. But really, there's nothing to see here anyway. Shouldn't you be heading to Restoration Chamber number 3 to meet me?
Seems very untrustworthy. A flashlight. Oh, cool. Can I use the flashlight? It doesn't seem like it. Engineering drawing, a bell. Oh, I'm taking my key card back because I need it to get the hell out of here. That seems pretty obvious. Alright, let's go check out Restoration Station 3. One to two is just nothing. There's wait, what? It would be very handy to have a flashlight here. Ooh, okay. Some more stuff to go snoop through. Chessboard. It doesn't show up as an actual object, so probably won't be doing anything with that chessboard. What's with all these cables? Very disconcerting. The off-kilterness of that text is, like, kind of screwing with me.
You know, we do tell them not to leave the pre-designated path, to stick to the memory routes laid out for them. But do they listen? Of course they bloody well don't. And unfortunately, recovery isn't always an option. Once you experience the deep recesses of another consciousness.
Boy, it should be. Would be nice if those boxes were a little bit bigger to actually activate from.
A tool to cure disease and illness. But it would be nothing without the likes of you. Right. Would you be a dear and help me with the setup? I need the electrical input for the Rembrandt installation rerouting. You can access it from that terminal over there.
Oh, here we go. They opened up that wall. Only accepts 300 something? I removed the fuse and it still blew up.
We need to replace the fuse. You'll need to take the blown one out and replace it with the correct fuse. By the computers over there.
Seventy-five, 120, 300. 75, 300A, 300A. Doo doo doo. 75, eh? Okay. Oh, there's my first trophy for this game. That is some ominous goddamn sound.
That should do it. Right.
Where's my keycard?
Thank you for that. Always nice to get some help around here. Now, if you don't mind, I think it's time to take a seat.
If you say so. Wamp.
Right. A few things before we project. Our client, Gene, is currently in a very delicate state.
She got dementia with Louis bodies. Louis body dementia, that's what I think Robin Williams was diagnosed with? Posthumously. That doesn't look sinister at all. So now we're going into Magneto? Makes sense.
Are you ready?
No. Guess it doesn't matter. Pinwheel.
Okay, listen up. You are in your case. You're probably going to come back here a lot, so please take some time to get acquainted with your surroundings. It keeps most restorers' sanity intact. For a short while, anyway.
Press triangle to teleport to and from the case. What the mind thinks, the heart transmits. Okay, then. Pinwheel Industrial, Pinwheel Village. Pinwheel Harbor, Brimcliff Mines. Oh, we've got a vault. I'm gonna find more dials to add to that. That seems like what I'm probably gonna end up doing. Working shower, always nice to see. Does the sink work too? Sink does not work. Nor does the toilet. Nice. Yes, I get it. Press triangle to teleport to and from the case. I want to explore the case first. Okay, what are these? Like, they have handles, like I should be able to pull them out like drawers or something. Okay. There's a bed that I can't use. Statue of Mary, guitar that I can strum. Bunch of blank windows. Or panels? Yeah, probably panels. Alright, let's teleport.
Our sole purpose this evening is to track the memory and pinpoint its location so we can cleanse it of any disease present. Everything you're seeing in front of you is a visual environment pieced together from our client's subconscious mind. Barren wastelands or an abstract painting reimagined. It's all completely tangible. All I can see are brain scans of tissue degradation confirming my previous diagnosis of dementia. Both are incredibly important if we are to succeed and understand our client's needs. Now, if you just give me a second, I'll have some more details for you. Feel free to explore in the meantime.
I intend to. Cave. Hey. I've seen this before. Continue on the path, I guess. Devlin Mine.
worth noting that if you feel an item might be useful later on in your journey, and you have no use for it now, you can always store it in the case and collect it at any time.
Slightly pack routing it up. Oh my god, settle down, guys. Oh, Jesus. So much stuff. How do I get down further? Okay, so that's how I get down further. There's a second floor that I can't get up to? Oh, it's just like wood planks, okay. There's unlikely to be anything actually up there. Alright, let's go down the path a bit.
Readings indicate that the central focus of this memory is located below you, in an old abandoned mine known as Devlin. Entry 95D in our client's memory journal indicates that an accident occurred affecting them in a meaningful way.
Arsenic, Jesus. And let's store the plates. I'm not sure what use it has, but let's store it anyways. One 6 7 0. Ha 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 ha. I knew it had to have a use. I knew it. Oops. That's moderately useless. Now, am I supposed to go down from here? Because I don't want to go the way I'm supposed to go at the moment. I want to go explore some more so I can grab ancillary shit. To interact with down here. So, upstairs and through that side hallway? Over here. Alright, so we need 1 6 7 0.
Okay.
Excellent.
So, I've been digging a little deeper into our client's personal history, and I found details of a strong emotional response to someone who once worked within the mine. An entry that discusses the mine at great length, but doesn't discuss whom the individual was that worked there. Continue to work your way down, further into the mine. It seems the center of this memory is very much at the heart of these industrial ratways. I'll contact you if I gain any more information.
Alright, so the air valve should be open. Exhaust should be closed. Furnace goes left, steam valve goes right. Left, right. Left, left, right. Left, right. Ha ha ha. Is that gonna drain the water? Yep, it's gonna drain the water. Fantastic. That is peculiar. Take the shovel, cannot take the shovel. Ooh, it's getting dark. Spooky. That's a press. Okay. It's a press. And I shall be taking this lantern. Or not? Nope, can't take the lantern. Sounded like needlessly spooky.
Sounds, sights, and smells can help store memories forever.
A projector. I'm not sure how they got here, but I think they relate to our patient's history. Don't worry, you won't need these to progress this evening as they're an optional task, but we should at least give this one a try. I'll store important notes like this downstairs in the case for you. They'll be there whenever you want to have a look at them.
Alright, the air compression manual. It's supposed to be somewhere past the gate, I do believe.
Things we touch throughout our life can stay with us in the back of our minds.
And let's go ditch whatever the hell this chemical is. Well, there's nothing I can interact with. That's not a door, it's like a reinforced wall or something. Okay, well, I guess we'll have to go find where that air compression guide is. Oh, unless we can't return up. That's awesome. Okay, so we are stuck down here. Did I miss something in the notes? Find the book and return it, but that's... supposed to be doing here. So I can't pick up that lamp. Or that lantern. Lantern? Lantern. Ugh. There's an empty birdcage. Door that I can't open. Rubber pipe. Rubber pipe. Isopropyl ethyl thiocarbamate. I have no idea what that does. Using the wrench does nothing. Can I press the wrench to flatten it out? Nope. But it does seem like I'm supposed to press something. Just haven't the faintest idea what. The bottle?
Although both keys are fragmented, they hold the key to remembering the way we were.
that wasn't important.
That door didn't open. Alright, let's put the bottle shards back, I guess. Seriously? Damn it. I didn't actually grab it.
Spray of perfume and it all comes flooding back.
I found the manual. Woo. Now is this gonna tell me how to repair these things properly, or just gonna have to start wrecking pipes again? That's weird.
At roughly 3 p.m.
Oh.
We had a breakthrough. I sprayed a small amount of the perfume that the next of kin provided on the back of the armchair. Although there wasn't any verbal acknowledgement at this stage, I found that the patient seemed to be calm throughout the entire session. I'm going to wash it off tomorrow and see if there's a direct difference, and if so, I may use it as an aid in future sessions.
I don't know where you are in there or what it looks like to you, but our readings have trebled in the last few seconds. You must be incredibly close to the center of this memory. I think...
You think? Hey, a gem.
There it is. Our readings, they're showing that this is what's causing the symptoms of dementia in our patient. Or at least it's part of what's causing it.
Crush the stone.
Destroy it any way you can. Once the task is done, I'll be able to extract you from the memory and place you in another.
Any way it can. You can't trust it.
Alright. You're getting squished. Automatically.
Moments, like stars, are passing me by, burning so bright and so fast as if they never truly existed at all. They're so beautiful, so fragile. I want to hold on to them. I want to hold on and never let them go. Why can't I hold on anymore? Please.
Man, so far I'm kind of really digging this.
Inside. Now, the objective as stated is to locate Jean's artifact. At this present moment in time, we don't know what this item is. We need to gather information from important memories our client can still understand. Their core memories.
Whoa. Okay. Is there any way to go back to places I've already been? I can. Oh, that's awesome. Wait, this isn't where I was. Can't actually travel back to that place. Weird. Well, I've got some supper waiting for me, you guys, so that's going to be where I'm going to call for tonight. Judging by how much I'm digging this right now, I'm probably going to do an up all night for either one, probably Saturday night. Probably start that at about 10 p.m., I guess. So you can look forward to that. Remember, I'm corrupt. You can like, follow, subscribe on Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, all that jazz. I'm corrupt for Twitter, /I'm corrupt for Twitch, /I'm corrupt91 for YouTube. And I normally stream Monday to Thursday, 6 to 7 p.m. Pacific time. Like I said, probably Saturday night we're going to do an up all night stream as much or the rest of as much as I can get done of either one. So look forward to that. But until then, I'm outie. Have a good night, folks. Toodles.